Blackstone Audiobooks presents the Hollywood Theatre of the Year production of The Sherlock Holmes Theatre. Two plays by Sir Arthur Conan Doyle and an afterpiece. And now, Sherlock Holmes, a play in four acts by William Gillette and Sir Arthur Conan Doyle. The scene is Edelweiss Lodge, a gloomy old house in a lonely district of London.
The evening paper, Mum.
I'll give it here.
Pardon, Mum, but one of the maids wishes to speak to you.
I can't spare the time now.
Very well, Mum.
Which maid was it?
Therese, Mum.
Therese?
Yes, Mum.
Have you any idea what she wants?
Not the least, Mum.
Well, she must tell you I'm very busy and I can't see her unless I know.
She refuses, Mum. She insists that she must speak to you herself.
Tell her to wait till tomorrow.
I asked her to do that, Mum, and she said she would not be here tomorrow.
Johnson, how did you happen to imagine that I would be interested in this marriage announcement?
Oh, I could hardly help it, Mum.
I suppose you have overheard certain references to the matter between myself and my brother?
I have, Mum. But I would never have referred to it in the least if I did not think it might be of some importance to you, Mum.
Oh, no. Of no special importance. We know the parties concerned and are naturally interested in the event. Of course, you do not imagine there is anything more.
Oh, certainly not, Mum. Anyway, if I did imagine there was something more, I'm sure you would find it in your interest, Mum, to remember my faithful services in helping to keep it quiet.
Johnson, what sort of a fool are you? You are a self-confessed forger.
No, don't speak out like that. It was in confidence. I told you in confidence, Mum.
Well, I'm telling you in confidence that at the first sign of any underhand conduct on your part, this little episode of yours
will... Yes, I will bear it in mind, Mum. I will bear it in mind.
Very well. Now, as to the maid, Therese, can you explain why she says she will not be here tomorrow?
It has occurred to me, Mum, that she might have taken exception to some occurrences which she thinks she has seen going on in this house.
I'll raise her wages. If it isn't money that she wants, I'll see her myself. Bring her to me.
Madge!
Very well, Mum.
Have you seen this?
Yes. Didn't you see Sid?
No, he wasn't there. We'll have to get a locksmith in to open the safe.
No, we can't do that. It's dangerous.
We've got to do something, haven't we? There's no time to waste either. They've put Holmes on the case.
Sherlock Holmes?
Yes.
What could he do?
I don't know. But he'll make some move. He never waits long.
Well, can't you think of someone else, as we can't find Sid?
He may turn up yet. I left word with Billy Rounds, and he's on the hunt for him. It is damnable. After holding on for 2 good years just for this... Now the time comes and she's blocked us. Look here. I'll just get at her for a moment. I have an idea I can change her mind.
No, wait, Jim. What's the use of hurting the girl? We've tried all that.
Well, I'll try something else.
Now, Jim, remember, nothing that'll show. No marks.
I'll look out for that.
Madam?
Eh, what? Oh, Therese, what do you want?
Mr. Justin said I was to come.
I told Judson to arrange with you himself.
He could not, madame. I do not wish longer to remain.
What is it? You must give me some reason.
It is that I wish to go.
You've been here months and have made no complaint.
Oui, madame. It is not so before. It is now beginning that I do not like.
What? What is it you do not like?
I do not like it, madame. This place, what you do, the young lady you have up there, I cannot remain to see. It is not well. I cannot remain to see.
Ah, you know nothing about it. The young lady is ill. She is not right in the head. She is a great trouble to us, but we take every care of her and treat her with the utmost kindness and concern.
Mon Dieu!
Don't be alarmed, my dear. Poor Miss Faulkner's head is very bad today. But she...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.